In this illustration, we'll study the rate of energy transfer to transverse waves in a string. We are given that if a string is horizontally stretched with a tension F in it and its one end oscillates vertically by a source with equation y is E sin omega t, where A is small. And due to these oscillations, a transverse wave is set up in a string. We are required to find the rate at which energy is supplied by oscillating source to a string and the maximum rate at any instant this energy is supplied. We are given with the linear mass density as mu. So, in this situation, if we draw the picture of a string which is attached over the source and if it is oscillating vertically, then at any instant we can see if the shape of a string looks like this. We can see a transverse wave is set up in the string which travels at a speed v. Then this particle which is oscillating up and down between plus A and minus A, having equation given by A sin omega t. And at any instant this would be moving up with the velocity v and the tension would be acting in the string in tangential direction which we can consider as F. And due to the vertical component of this F only, the energy is being extracted from the source to string. So, we can calculate at any instant slope of a string is, the slope we can calculate as del y by del x as the equation is given by A sin omega t. The slope of a string, we are calculating it at x equals to 0. So, this del y by del x can be given by y. When we differentiate it with respect to x, the equation of this simple harmonic wave we can write as A sin of omega t minus kx, where k is 2 pi by lambda if lambda is the wavelength. So, we calculate del y by del x, this will give us minus ak cos of omega t minus kx, and as we substitute x is equals to 0, this gives us del y by del x is equals to tan theta, which is the slope of this curve at this point. So, if this angle is theta, we can write tan theta, which is minus ak cos of omega t. And if we calculate the speed of this oscillating particle, then we can calculate at x equals to 0, the speed of oscillator particle is, this is speed v in y direction, we can write as del y by del t, which is given as A omega cos of omega t minus kx. And again at x equals to 0, if we substitute x as 0, this is A omega cos of omega t. This is the speed of this particle. And as the tension is acting as F, we can write that power supplied to a string by oscillator is, this power we can write as F sin theta multiplied by Vy. As the string will be having this negative power because it is extracting energy, so the power which the source is supplying is given by F sin theta multiplied by Y. As source will be exerting a force in opposite direction, so that will supply a positive power. So, for a small theta, we can write it as F tan theta multiplied by Vy. And here this is given by F multiplied by, here tan theta we already calculated as AK cos omega t. And the value of K we can write either as 2 pi by lambda or as omega by V. So, in this situation, this V is the wave velocity and this Vy is the velocity of particle we are using. So the value of tan theta here we can write as A omega by V multiplied by cos of omega t multiplied by Vy is given as A omega cos of omega t. So this will give us the power which is given as this numerical value is F A square omega square by a wave velocity we can write as, this we can simply write as root of F by mu. So we write it as root of F by mu multiplied by cos square omega t, which gives us root of F mu multiplied by A square cos square omega t. That is the result of this problem. And from here, if we calculate the maximum power, then the maximum value of this power can directly be given as root of F mu multiplied by A square omega square, as this value will be maximum when cos square omega t will be 1. So this is the result of the maximum power rate at which it is being supplied to the string.